गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स द थर्ड लेसन ऑफ योर पाइथन फॉर बीसीए थर्ड सेमेस्टर एज पर द सिलेबस ऑफ आईके गुजराल पंजाब टेक्निकल यूनिवर्सिटी जलंधर। इट्स पार्ट वन ऑफ यूनिट वन, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज। द टॉपिक टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज रनिंग पाइथन, how to run Python, how to write your first Python program, and what are the Python interactive help features. First of all, how to run Python program. To run Python program, go to your desktop and right click. Then after right clicking, you will find new, then click on text document. You can open the new text document and write a simple program of Python. Starting with hash, with the help of hash you can write comments, and in the second line you can write print in double quotes, "Hello world." Then save the program as sample.py on the desktop, or you can write any name, but keep in mind the extension. The extension should be py. Then click on save. In this way, you can save one Python file, sample.py. Then go to command prompt. After searching, you can find command prompt. By default, command prompt is like this: C, users, and your name. My name is Sukhvir, that's why it goes to Sukhvir. And as per your system, it will go to that particular point. Then click on CD desktop so that you can enter into the desktop. Then write the simple command Python, then name of your Python program .py, then click enter. You can execute the program. Second one is Python interactive help feature. Go to command prompt or go to search option and click on IDLE, Python 3.7 32-bit, if you already install this content. Otherwise, install Python IDLE. The interactive shell in my system is Python 3.7.4, but it may vary with your version. Maybe you have the latest version. Then type help, and inside help write print, then click enter. You can find the help for print, how print is working. Similarly, you can find help for other variables. The summary of today's lecture: how to run Python program using command prompt, use of help feature in IDLE. One more thing you have to note: click on my PC or this PC, then go to properties, click advanced system setting, then go to environment variables, then click on new. Here you have to write path and the location where Python is placed before executing the program in DOS prompt. I have already set the path, this one. Then click on edit. You can see here, this one is required. Why I have written this variable with value? Now, close this. Go to this PC, then C drive, and check the folder here, Python 27, this one. This folder is required, this path is required basically. Whatever the path or whatever the name on your system, you have to give the path in environment variables. I repeat again, click on this PC or right click on this PC, then go to properties, then advanced setting, environment variables, and check here whether path is given or not. Otherwise, click on new and you have to write here path and then C colon backslash Python 27 as per my PC. Let us execute some programs. File, new file, first of all, what is the difference between format and round? Suppose I have to calculate the area of circle. For that, I have to write import math, then pi is equal to math dot pi. This value is required. Then r is equal to int input in double quotes, then write radius, then area is equal to pi r square. After that, we can print the value of the area. Now print area. Now execute. Before execution, you have to give the name. Then radius 12. Now, what about area? It's 452.389 something like this. Suppose I use round here, print round ar, comma 3. Now execute again. Value is 12. It means I can display the content up to 3 places of decimal. Now, what is the difference between round and format? Suppose I write here format inside bracket area, then 0.2f like this. Then execute again, 12, it's 452.39. Suppose I write 10.2. Now look at the difference. 12. What is the difference here? Any idea? These total numbers are 10 and 2 points are after decimal. So, as I write here, let's copy and paste this content. Suppose I write 11.4. Then execute the program. 12. Look at the answer. Now, what is the meaning of 11? The total count is 11. And after decimal, 4 points are there. It is the major difference between round and format. I repeat again, in case of round, you can set only the numbers. That what is the count of the digits after decimal. But in format, you can set the total numbers also. Now, what about the next one? I'm going to discuss some more contents. The second one is, suppose I write print, then format 0.786123, comma, in double quotes, 7.3%. Now, what is the meaning of this? 78.612. Now, total count is 7. And the values after the decimal is 3. Suppose I write 11.3. Then execute. Now, look at the size. It increases. And the value after decimal is 3. Suppose I write only 786. Now, check the answer. It's 78600. 0.000. Now, what is the meaning of this? Total count is 11. Look at the value 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. 11 count is there, and after decimal, 3 values are there. This one is the concept of percentage. Next one is, suppose I write absolute, then inside bracket 12. Now execute this. Answer is 12. Suppose I write 12.1, then output is 12.1. If I write the negative value, the output is again positive value. Now, what is the meaning of ABS? ABS stands for positive value. Now, next one is math dot. Use math, we have to write import math, then math dot load. Suppose I write 12.5. Look at the answer. Answer is 12. But if I am using print math dot seen, then 12.7, like this. And execute the program. The answer is 13. Now, what is the meaning of ceiling and floor? Suppose I am using 12.5. It means 12.5 lies in between 12 and 13. It means floor value is 12 and ceiling value is 13. If we have to calculate the square root of the value, then I can use SQRT. Suppose I am writing 13. You can calculate the square root directly. Similarly, if you have to calculate factorial of the number, you can calculate directly the factorial of the number, that is 5 multiply 4 multiply 3 multiply 2 multiply 1, that is 120. Thanks for watching the content.